So this is what they are asking you to calculate. So in this sum, we are supposed to calculate payback period. Okay, we are doing this for payback period. The question is elaborated here. The cost of investment is rupees 2 lakhs for project P. And for project Q, the cost of investment is 2 lakhs 80. Expected life is, both of them have same expected life, 5 years. Projected income after depreciation, interest and taxes. What is projected income? It has been given for 5 years and the projected net income means projected net profit. So net profit is after depreciation, after interest and after tax. Everything is after. Okay, means we are given after tax, because after depreciation and after tax means after tax only. So what is that we need? What is that we need? What kind of net profit we are supposed to calculate?
Net profit after tax. No, sorry. Yes. After tax, before depreciation.
But before depreciation. Very good. So already they are giving net profit after tax. So what is the step that we need to do? Only one step that is pending, and that is adding back depreciation is pending. Only one step is pending. Adding depreciation. Adding back depreciation, we will get net profit after tax, but before depreciation. So only one step that has to be done is adding back the depreciation in the given net profits. So how many years of net profits are given? 5 years. We have two projects, P and Q. So we will do first we will do with P and second with Q. Okay, let's start. Write down. Should I be doing it or... Okay, I'll open the Word document. Wait. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We have sum number 7. Tell me, is this question which is given in... Now, is this question related to uniform inflows or ununiform inflows? What is it? It is
ununiform.
PVP. Yes, ununiform PVP. Okay, so what is step number 1? Calculation of CI.
PVP.
Yes.
Oh, sorry, no. PI.
CI. I'm sorry. And CCI. Okay, koi baat nahi. The first step is calculation of CI and CCI. At that point only we will calculate CCI also. Why we need to make another table? Why to waste time? So let's do it in step 1 only. Okay, anyways we are making table. So how many columns we would need? We would need first column for year. Second column for net profit after tax. Third column for adding back the depreciation. Fourth column, we will get net profit after tax but before depreciation, which is my CI. And fifth column, we need it to make cumulative CI. So in all, we have to make 5 columns. Okay. This is here. Okay. This is year. This is net profit after tax, which is already given in the question. Now we have to add back the depreciation. We will get CI, which is nothing but net profit after tax but before depreciation. And the last column is CCM. Okay. How many years we have?
5.
5 years. So what is the amount of first year? Okay, I'll show up the screen. We are doing it project P. So humko na yahan pe pehle likhna padega. See, we have to write here first. Project in inverted commas P. Project P. And yes, I forgot to write one more thing, which is cost of the project. Cost of P project. Cost of P project. What is the cost of P project?
2 lakhs. 2 lakhs, ma'am.
2 lakhs is the cost. Am I right? Am I going right?
Yes, ma'am.
ठीक है. Project P. We are doing for Project P. Cost of Project P is 2 lakhs. Okay. Now step number one is calculation of CI and CCI. So the first year's profit is 10. Next 10, 20, 20, 20. So first year is 10. Okay. We have second year as 10. Third year as 20. Fourth year as again 20.
20.
Yes. And the fifth year again has
20.
Very good. Now depreciation. Is it given in the question? Look at the question. Is it given? Somewhere? Depreciation is 10,000, 40,000, 90,000. Is it given in the terms of amounts? No, it is not given. But here you can see a line is given, a statement is given, which says you may assume the straight line depreciation. What do you mean by that? We need to calculate the depreciation. While calculating, we have to use the formula for depreciation. What is the formula? Cost minus scrap upon life. And can you see in a bracket here, it is written no salvage. Expected life has a bracket, and in the bracket it says no salvage. No salvage means no scrap value. No scrap value. No salvage means no scrap value. So, because
40,000
is given, cost is 2 lakhs and life is 3. Here I would calculate for you all. Here I would calculate the depreciation. What is the formula for depreciation? Cost minus scrap divided by life, estimated life. So the cost of the project is, what is the cost of project?
2 lakhs.
Yes, divided. No scrap value means you can leave it. And what is the life of the project? 5 years. So divided by 5. It is already given in the question. Okay. So what is my final answer?
40,000.
Sorry, it's 40. Sorry. It would be 40,000. Okay. So the depreciation is 40,000. So the depreciation is 40,000. Straight line means same for every year. It would be same. Okay. Okay. Adding back. Now, adding back the depreciation in net profit, we would get the first amount as 50,000, if I'm not wrong. Next one also would be 50. Yes. Next one would be 60. Okay, next one also 60, because the figures are same. But that doesn't mean that it is uniform inflow. It is ununiform. Now, CCI. First column would be always same, 50,000 as same as CI. Next, now this 50.
1 lakh.
Yes, this 50 has to be added back in second 50 of CI. It would be 1 lakh. See, it's nothing new for you. Therefore, I'm not putting so highlights. Now, this 1 lakh has to be added in third year's figure of CI. third year figure of CI 60. So it becomes 1,60,000. Now this 1,60,000 has to be added in fourth year's figure of CI. So it would be 2,20,000 if I'm not wrong. Yes. 2,20,000. Yes, sorry, I'm writing in the wrong column. This would be 2,20,000. Now this 2,20,000 has to be added in the last column of CI 60,000.
2,80,000.
Yes. So final amount would be 2,80,000. Now what is my cost? Cost is my 2,00,000. I should have recovered 2,00,000 rupees. Okay. But in which year I am recovering the whole amount of 2,00,000 rupees? In fourth year. Fourth year, I have recovered the total amount of 2,20,000. This means I have recovered 2,00,000. In fact, I have recovered 20,000 extra. In fact, I have recovered 20,000 above 2,00,000. Okay. So 2,00,000, the whole amount is fully recovered in the fourth year. Okay, but in the formula, we don't have to write fourth year. We have to write third year. Why? Because it says year before full recovery. So my second step would be, calculation of
PBP.
Yes, very good. So PBP is equals to year before
full recovery.
Yes, full recovery. Then
bracket unrecovered unrecovered amount divided by inflow of that year.
Very good. Unrecovered amount divided by inflow of that year. That year means the year in which full recovery is done. Full recovery is made. Bracket close. So now how to solve it? First, he is saying year before full recovery. In which year you have recovered the full amount? In which year you have recovered full amount? Is fourth year. Can you see fourth year? Look at the column of CCI. CCI has fourth year. Fourth year has 2,20,000 in CCI column. So it is matching 2,00,000? Yes. In fact, it is above 2,00,000. That is okay. But then it should have been recovered the whole amount. And it is recovering. So, fourth year. But we don't have to write fourth year. We have to write third year. Because they are asking the year before full recovery. Before means the previous year. This is plus. Bracket. Unrecovered amount. Now look at the third column's third year's CCI. Look at the third year's CCI. Why third year? Because outside the bracket, we have written third year. So in third year, what was the amount which I couldn't recover? What was the amount which I couldn't recover is by deducting 2,00,000 minus 1,60,000. Because see, it says in third year, up to third year, I could recover 1,60,000. Up to third year, I could recover rupees 1,60,000 out of 2,00,000 rupees. So what is unrecovered? What is left behind is 40,000, which I could not recover. So here I have to write unrecovered amount as 40,000, very simple. So 40 divided by what? Inflow of that year. Inflow means CI. Not CCI. Inflow of that year. That year means fourth year. That year means fourth year. Now look at the column of look at the CI column of fourth year. It is 60,000. Very good. Yes, bracket close. So next step is writing down 3 plus as same. Opening the bracket, we will get what is 40 by 60?
0.67.
Yes. Opening the bracket, we will get 0.67. You have to open the bracket. Please note that. Please note it. While solving the bracket, you have to open the bracket. Again and again, we will not put it in the bracket. No? That will be wrong then. So what is the final answer? 3 plus 0.67 is 3.67 watts. Yes. That means recovering 2,00,000 will take to recover 2 lakhs, it will take 3 years, 6 months, 7 days. So around 3.5 years. Okay, is it clear to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so much job is done. Then see, it's so easy. And now you are supposed to do with Q project. I hope you have done P project with me. Now start with Q project. Start with. I'm giving you only 3 to 4 minutes to complete with project Q, and I need the final answer. I'm giving you
ma'am, question.
Yes, I will open the question before you. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so start with the project Q. 3-4 minutes are there. Okay, I believe you all are done with the project Q. And yes, the final answer is
3.5 years.
Very good. Okay. And that is right. Now let's start with another one. Wait, let me choose this one. Sailesh Company Limited has invested in a machine at cost of rupees 10 lakhs. The machine cost him rupees 10 lakhs. Estimated life is 5 years. Tax rate is 50%. Depreciation on straight line method, SLM. Okay, you have 5 years profits, but profit is before depreciation. 4 lakhs, 6 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 50. This profit is given before depreciation. But we need not calculate the profit before depreciation. We want profit
after tax but before depreciation.
Very good. So this is sum number 8, which is ununiform again. Ununiform PBT, of course. By now you have understood. Okay, only one project is given, only one machine. There are no bifurcation into two machines, P and Q, A and B. Therefore, only machine cost has to be written. Machines cost. What is machine's cost? What is the cost of machine? 10 lakhs.
10 lakhs.
Yes. Now, we can start with step number 1. What is step number 1? Tell me calculation of
CI and CCI.
Very good. CI and CCI. How many columns now? See, while making the columns, you have to think over, not just blindly making the columns. You have to think over and make the columns. See, first column is year, second net profit before depreciation, which is already given. After, now net profit before depreciation is given. So what you need to do the next step? No. Net profit before depreciation is given. Before.
Depreciation.
No. Who is answering me? Who is this? Is it... who has answered me? Priya has answered me.
नो मैम जयश्री.
जयश्री बेटा एड डेप्रिसिएशन हम तब करते हैं जब नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स दिया होता है. एक मिनट रुको, मैं आपको एक डॉक्यूमेंट दिखाती हूँ, ये वाला. इसमें आप याद करो हमने क्या किया था. ये फॉर्मेट याद है सबको? ये फॉर्मेट याद नहीं होगा ना आप सम नहीं कर पाएंगे. देखो सेल्स में से क्या माइनस करते हैं? COGS. तो क्या मिलता है? नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर डेप्रिसिएशन. ये मिला हुआ है. दिस इज व्हाट इज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, नेट
डेप्रिसिएशन.
सो हाउ मेनी स्टेप्स वी हैव टू डू? वी हैव टू डिडक्ट द डेप्रिसिएशन, वी हैव टू डिडक्ट द टैक्स, वी हैव टू एड बैक द डेप्रिसिएशन, एंड फाइनली वी विल अराइव टू अ फाइनल आंसर व्हिच इज CI, व्हिच वुड बी CI फॉर मी. So there are three steps that we need to go. And Jayashree, you are giving me only the final step. If net profit after tax was given, then you would have added depreciation directly. But net profit before depreciation is given. So now you first have to deduct depreciation. You will get net profit after depreciation before tax. You have to deduct tax. You will arrive to a net profit which is known as after tax. Adding back depreciation, you will get CI.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So because you have understood, I'll shift on to the page where we are doing some. I'll insert a table. First column, year. Next column, net profit before depreciation. Now you all tell me, the third column would be
less depreciation.
Very good, less depreciation. What we are
tax?
No, less depreciation के बाद हमको क्या मिलेगा? क्या मिलेगा?
Net profit
after depreciation and before tax. Yes, very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, before tax. So what has to be done? Less tax. Fifth column, less tax. We will get net profit after tax. Okay. We have to add back the depreciation in seventh column. We will get CI in the eighth column. In the ninth column, we will have CCI. So total in all, we have nine columns. Therefore, I am doing the sum. I'm not giving you as an homework. Okay. Here, net profit. Profit before depreciation. We have to deduct the depreciation. We will get net profit after depreciation and before tax. Okay. Net profit after tax and before, after, sorry. This is after depreciation. Net profit after depreciation and before tax. So, what we need to do? Less tax.
Yeah.
Okay. Less tax. We will get net profit after tax. Adding back depreciation, we will get CI. Last column would be CCI. By now, I hope it's clear. How many years are given in the question? Sorry. I need to shift on to a PDF. 1.5. So, first year's profit is mute. 4 lakhs. First year's profit is 4 lakhs. Second year's profit is 6 lakhs. Third year's profit would be, what was that? 4 lakhs and 5 lakhs. 5 lakhs. And fifth year would be? Yes,
4 lakhs 50,000.
Okay, very good. Now depreciation. I want depreciation to be deducted first. So depreciation is not given in the question. If you can see, depreciation is not given. You need to calculate the depreciation.